Egyptologist, is a spoken word artist who has had the privilege of touring across the country with nationally known artists for the past 6 years. Tonight, she would like to present to you, and for all you, an original poem titled The Letters of the Wanderer. Let's go, Egypt!
Okay, so I have to give the speech every time I do this. Spoken word poetry is poetry that's meant to be presentational, meaning that when I wrote it, I really hoped that I'd have the opportunity and privilege to give it to fine people such as yourself, so thank you very much. This poem deserves just a little bit of explanation just because of who it was written for. As Johnny said, I've had the honor and the privilege of being able to share poetry with a bunch of people for the last 6 years of my life. And The Letters of a Wanderer is from a kid I met at a concert. And to him, I was a guitarist in the band who was coming through, and he asked me if I could write a poem or a song for some of the things that he's seen and some of the stuff that he's gone through. So The Letters of a Wanderer is a gift to him and maybe a reminder to everyone else for things that may seem strange to us as we are strangers in a completely different land, especially when we're not home. So without further ado, I present to you The Letters of a Wanderer. I am a wanderer. For whatever reason, I packed up and I began to roam without a plan or a home or a pillow to call my own. And the tone of my life became only to know the unknown. And with that, I threw myself overboard and I drowned in the sea of the world that I set out to be. I walked a plank of my own creation, flanked by my hopefulness and my restless desire for the fire of my heart to be the daily art that hit the dart of idealism and realism of my fantasy on the head. But instead, I drowned in an ocean of dogma and liturgy. I am a stranger. I'm a ranger in a park of my own invention that serves as the prevention of my return. The green ferns blocking out the sun, the days unnumbered, this territory is still unwanted. That is when I began my mission, when my sole ambition was to bring into fruition the dreams I had when I set out without a bed. All I wanted to do was wed the proof that my utopian society was anything but dead, that the propriety of an existing nation would have the innovations needed for someone to have succeeded my dreams, schemes, and inventions. Only come to the realization that I was wrong. See, I have come a long, long way through many trials every day, and the only thing I can say is that you're all just a little strange, little deranged, maybe insane in the membrane, or though you could always just be changed. Now look, I may not have a place where I belong, but as long as that's the case, can I serve as the face for the culture shock that rang out and mocked the idealistic peace that once surrounded and anchored me to my fragile rock of the shots I can hear out on the corner of any neighborhood, followed by the shouts of nothing that can be good. However, many people will distance themselves from this forced segregation of what a lot of people will refer to as the hood. Well, sir, in your bright, shiny suit, I think it is a mute point, seeing as your hands are now anointed with the indecency of returning home after a night of doing things you don't want anyone to see as you two drowned in the sea of my dystopian society. There are boys reading books like men get hooked on obsessions from depression to suppression of everyday feelings just because the dealing of cards came down hard on just us few. Of the two boys I see, both standing so sure, one holds a piece of literature that I am pretty sure very few middle schoolers have heard of. It is To Kill a Mockingbird. It's been banned for its use of the N-word. While the other carries a hand cannon, wary of apprehension. It is not the invention of my imagination that even today in this nation, only one of these things is illegal, and it is not the one who had to steal his copy from the library. In fact, it's the one who had to take his from his father's closet just because his family wasn't cautious enough to lock it. But never mind. As wary as both of these are for their misdeeds, neither of them will know that they will feed in the statistics of those who don't fit the MO of children killed on gunshot rows. Two men further down the street misfire aim a little higher than meant, and there went both of those boys' chance at a life over a strife they had nothing to do with. I am a wanderer. I have seen many different things, many different lands, and on the other hand, I feel like they are all one and the same, same joy, same pain, just under different names. I don't belong here, and I'm glad, for fear that I may conform to the norm of becoming callous to the scornful looks on the mugshots, plot the horror of the gunshots, or even plot out a page of our history for simply being scary. Be careful, young locals. Be fearful for your identity. Don't become lost in a sea of demands without a life jacket to lend a hand without demanding something from you. I and my friends are only passing through, and I know a few of you will understand. I know that there's somewhere out there with a hand over me, fighting for me, tending for me to be whatever I want to be, and while my story may not be finished or that great, I know that I can celebrate because I already know it's ending. So without lending itself to any more scrutiny, I will always believe, but still, some of you may not understand. I may not have a home of my own, but at least I can still remember who I am. Thank you.